Once you've selected the fill and comparison group criteria like we've done in the previous video, you are now ready to begin comparing rates and analyzing the results on the right. There are four dials in the North Carolina Rates dashboard: fill comparison, conservation signal, cost recovery, and affordability. The gauges have a familiar look to them. They look and operate like the gauges on your car dashboard. In fact, to go along with the car theme, you also see a lot of greens, yellows, and reds. Yes, they actually do mark different signals based on where your utility falls. Red is generally bad, and the green areas are a safe spot to be in, given what the gauge is portraying. Next to each gauge is a question mark. Click on one, and a pop-up appears explaining that gauge. Click on the X to close out of it. The first gauge is a bill comparison. This number at the bottom signifies the monthly bill your utility charges for the inputs you've selected on the left. Here, the example utility charges $62.25 monthly for water and sewer combined for 5,000 gallons per month of use. This number is basically the same as that number. The colors on the dial mark where the utilities that you are comparing yourself to lie. Basically, it marks where the blue dots on the map fall. In this case, we are comparing the example utility to the 65 rate structures that have a similar number of accounts, 500 to 1,000. The dark green area of the gauge indicates where the middle 50% lie in that comparison group. The dark green area is flanked on both sides by light green areas, which shows you where the middle 80% of the bills lie. The small numbers on the outside of the gauge show you that range for this middle 80%. So, in this case, the middle 80% of these 65 utilities charge between $37 a month to $87 a month. On either side of the light green areas, you'll find yellow portions of the gauge. The outer yellow portions show you where the highest 10% and lowest 10% of bills from this comparison group lie. The dial on the gauge points to where your utility charges and where it falls on that gauge. If your dial falls in any of the green areas, you're charging near what most of the utilities in your comparison group are charging. If your dial falls in the lower yellow area, you are charging less than 90% of the utilities. If your dial falls within the upper yellow area, you are charging more than 90% of the utilities in the comparison group. Either way, you should probably examine your cost structure and make sure your rates are appropriate. Notice that when you change your selections on the left, the dial moves to reflect your new position based on what you are now comparing. For example, if now I want to compare example utility to utilities with similar customer income, the map changes and the dial moves to the right, showing that the example utility is now charging more than the median, but still within the middle 50% of the utilities in this new comparison group. Next, let's look at the conservation signal gauge. The purpose of this gauge is to show the relative strength of the conservation pricing signals sent by the selected rate structure. There are lots of ways to measure the relative strength of a conservation message sent by a pricing structure. This particular gauge shows what the customer will be charged for the next 1,000 gallons of usage beyond 10,000 gallons per month. In other words, this is the actual rates, the dollars per 1,000 gallons, that the utility has set at the 10,000 gallons per month mark. The example utility charges $6.88 per 1,000 gallons at 10,000 gallons, meaning a customer that goes from 10,000 gallons of use in 1 month to 11,000 gallons the next month, will see his or her bill go up by an additional $6.88 for water and sewer combined. Since the average residential household water use is around 4,000 or 5,000 gallons per month, this gauge focuses on the price for usage at almost twice that amount. For many customers, most usage at this level is discretionary. It goes to things like car washing, lawn watering, etc. A utility that charges more for the water at this level of demand sends a stronger message that water conservation is important than a utility that charges less for water at this level. In this gauge, we split the rates charged by utilities in the comparison group into four quartiles. There's a dark yellow area, light yellow area, light green area, and a dark green area. The darkest green area on the right shows the highest 25% of rates, and the darkest yellow area shows the lowest 25% of rates among the 85 utilities of this comparison group. For this particular utility, compared to utilities serving customers with similar income, we see that the example utility's dial lands in the light yellow area. So we can say that they are sending a conservation signal that is greater than a quarter of these 85 other utilities, but less than half. As with the bill comparison, this gauge is based on the number of bills. This gauge is based on the bills of other utilities in the comparison group. Change the comparison group, and the bill dial moves to its new position. I always suggest looking at the all utilities option when looking at this dial. In this case, the example utility is still within that 25th to 50th percentile. In the next video, we will look at the other two gauges on the right.